Okay, everybody, this is John with NRSNG.com. Today we're going to talk about dopamine versus dobutamine. And we're going to have a chart available online that you can download. It's a PDF, and it will kind of go over everything we talk about here, just the basic differences between dopamine and dobutamine. And also it will cover some of the other vasopressors, or some of the vasopressors and their effect on systemic vascular resistance as well as cardiac output. So you can find that at nrsng.com/dopamine. All right, so why are we talking about dopamine versus dobutamine? Well, the reason is there seems to be some confusion. There was confusion in my mind as well, obviously, about what dopamine and dobutamine are and their differences. That's probably due to the names being somewhat similar and the fact that they're given in similar situations. Okay, so let's talk dopamine versus dobutamine. So first of all, we need to understand that dopamine is a vasopressor. Dobutamine is not a vasopressor. That's the first thing you really need to understand. Okay, dopamine is actually a vasopressor. It is actually an alpha 1 adrenergic agonist. So what that means is it's going to actually act on these alpha 1 receptors in the central nervous system, and by doing that, that's actually going to lead to an increased systemic vascular resistance. So these alpha 1 receptors are all along our vessels here, okay? So we have all these little alpha 1 receptors on our smooth muscles and in our you know, which include our vessels. And what happens is dopamine will actually go and act on these. And by acting on those, it's going to increase vasoconstriction. So as it acts on those alpha 1 receptors, these vessels are going to vasoconstrict and become tighter, and that's going to lead to increased systemic vascular resistance. Okay, so it's going to increase that vessel squeeze. Now dobutamine, on the other hand, is a positive inotrope. Now you remember, let's draw a little heart here. So here's our heart. And what these inotropes do, inotrope refers to the squeeze. How do you spell squeeze? Squeeze? Something like that. So inotrope refers to the squeeze of our ventricles. And so what positive inotropes actually do is they cause a greater squeeze, which is going to increase our cardiac output. So it's going to cause this left ventricle here to squeeze a little bit harder, and that's going to lead to more output here from our aorta. Okay? So the best way to think of this is, so dopamine vasopressor, alpha 1 agonist, dobutamine actually works on our beta 1 receptors in our central nervous system. So our beta 1 receptors, they're primarily found in the heart. And we talked about this a little bit earlier in another video about beta blockers and things like this. But beta 1 receptors are essentially, they're found in the heart. Okay, and so when beta 1 receptors are stimulated, this is part of our sympathetic nervous system, so it's part of our fight or flight. So as these receptors are stimulated, it's going to increase our heart rate, increase cardiac output, etc., etc. So what happens is, we give beta blockers to block all these effects, right? To block our beta receptor. Dobutamine, on the other hand, works to increase the effects of our fight or flight response, basically. So dobutamine is positive inotrope, works on our beta receptors, and it increases our cardiac output that way. It's a positive inotrope. Okay, so the best way for me to remember this is dobutamine has a B in it. Okay, so here's dobutamine with a B, and I think of that as beta. Okay, so it's a beta agonist. So it's going to increase the effects of the beta receptors. Dopamine, on the other hand, there's no B in it, so it's an alpha agonist. And what it's going to do is it's going to be a vasopressor. On the other hand, these beta receptors, stimulating these beta receptors do not lead to those vasopressive effects. Okay? So there's a quick overview for you. Let's go over to this chart that I have here, and we'll just talk about some of these things on this chart here. So dopamine is a vasopressor. Dobutamine is not. It's an inotrope, not a vasopressor. Dobutamine, with a B, exhibits primarily beta-1 effects to aid in increasing cardiac output. And dopamine, depending on the dosage, will exhibit an alpha-1 effect leading to vasoconstriction and therefore an increased systemic vascular resistance. It will also exhibit a beta-1 effect at lower doses. Dopamine is a great medication for septic shock because it will contribute to increased systemic vascular resistance. And dobutamine, on the other hand, is generally given to increase cardiac output. And it's used in heart failure and cardiogenic shock because at these doses it will lead to less myocardial oxygen demand. So that's great in heart failure and cardiogenic shock. Okay, so again, dopamine, for example, great in septic shock. Because in septic shock, remember what's happening here is we're having this massive vasodilation. And so we give our dopamine to go and act on these alpha receptors, and that leads to this vasoconstriction and increased systemic vascular resistance. So this is dopamine. And dobutamine over here, it's got our B in it, it's our beta. So what happens with dobutamine, and it's great for like heart failure, where our ventricles aren't wanting to contract, they're dilated or whatever, and cardiogenic shock as well. Because cardiogenic shock, our primary insult is a broken pump, so we have a decreased cardiac output. Heart failure, we also have a decreased cardiac output. So it's a great option for heart failure and cardiogenic shock because it's going to increase this squeeze and it's going to push more blood out here through the aorta. Okay, so that's why dobutamine and dopamine are given different situations. Best way to remember it is dobutamine, B, beta. Beta-1 receptors are in the heart. Dopamine, it's a vasopressor, works on the alpha-1 receptors. Okay, so what will be given away over at nrsng.com/dopamine is going to be this little chart here. What I really like about it also here is it takes different vasopressors and it ranks them in order of their effect on systemic vascular resistance and cardiac output. Okay, so this is a great little chart here. Go over there, it's free to use, free to distribute, do whatever you want with. Be sure to check us out on YouTube and listen to our other podcasts. We appreciate you listening. Contact me, this is John with NRSNG.com at contact@NRSNG.com. Thank you very much.